And see the sunshine from the rain. A lovely day.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Hi, and welcome to the Dream Show, where everyone's dreams matter. I'm your host, Jasmine. I've been a dreamer since the first grade, and I'm so happy to be here.
And I'm your co-host, Aaron. I have been a dreamer since the first grade, and I'll be attending college next year, and I would like to study mechanical engineering.
Hello, I'm your co-host, Evelyn. I'm on track to graduate this year, and I've overcome many challenges, like, for example, going country to country, selling gum and bread in the streets. Education has never been easy, but hey, here I am now.
To join us on the show today is our very own special guest host, fellow senior and soon-to-be graduate dreamer, Karan Brewer.
Woo! What's up, Karan?
What's up?
What's up, man?
Welcome, Karan. It's so nice to have you here with us today.
It's good to be here.
Good to see you, man. So, Karan, tell us a little bit about yourself. What inspires you?
Writing inspires me. I do a lot of writing. Mm. I was recently writing a script, and, you know, it was really long, you know, like 20 pages. So, it's really hard, but I got through it, so that's cool.
Wow, man, really? I like to write, too. I'm actually in journalism, and I really love to write. It's kind of like a good outlet. But I think that's really cool. Thanks for sharing that with us, Karan. We'll also like to hear from some of our viewers out here today. Hit us up on the Gram, Twitter, or Facebook with the hashtag DreamerForever to share your story.
Hey, Jasmine, What do you do to inspire you when you're feeling down?
I actually use a little recipe of mine that my friend Jamila taught me, which will probably brighten most of your days.
Okay, would you mind letting her show us?
Yeah, no problem.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, oh. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Hello, guys, I'm Jamila, and today I'm gonna show you the blessing jar. Now, this blessing jar helps you with all your troubles. When you feeling down, you come to this, and you count all your blessings. Now, to make this blessing jar, of course, you're going to need a jar. First, you take your tape. But before you rip the tape, you need to write something. You need to write, blessing jar. Like so. Then you take the tape and you cut it. Then you apply it to your jar. Like so. Then you take your pen and some post-it notes. Then you write one blessing every day. You could write something like, I woke up this morning. Then, take your post-it note, take it off, fold it up, and you simply place it into the jar. Like so. And that's it, folks. That's how you make your blessing jar. So next time you get sad, all you gotta do is count your blessings. All right, and that's all, folks. This little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine, oh, this little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine, this little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Oh, that was so sweet. I have so many things to be grateful for. I'll definitely give myself a blessing jar, too.
And oh, look, we have our first submission from our hashtag Dreams on Dreams Forever post from Euphoria XO. And they say, I grew up an only child, so it was a necessity to express myself creatively. I would probably become more bored and lonely, Oftentimes, I reveal my true inner thoughts through writing fictional stories or even writing songs based on instrumental hip-hop beats on YouTube. I am so thankful for this creative side of me because it helped translate what I normally do into my academics. Not only do I demonstrate my innovativeness by writing, but also by drawing.
That really speaks to me, seeing as I'm a writer too. It's really cool.
Yeah, I can kind of relate, although I'm not really that creative. I can barely draw a stick figure. But I actually listen to music, and music is kind of like an outlet for mm-hmm. me. And I guess you can say that's kind of my outlet,
yeah.
Music and dancing.
That's cool.
Yeah, I'm the same way with you, Jasmine. I just love music. It's just like, it speaks to my soul. It's just...
to your soul.
To my soul. Yes. It's just, ooh. Yeah.
What about you?
Well, me, I'm not really creative, but I do love music. I love dancing
my
Mexican
dance,
music. yes, I can. Excuse me. Of course I can. Okay. Well, yes, and you always need some support, you know, from your friends and family. Well, mm-hmm. Let's go ahead and see how you two support each other.
Mm. Everything okay, bro? You look a little down.
It doesn't matter, I'd rather not talk about it.
You sure? I'm here for you, bro. We could talk about this. Well, I'm not gonna let you sit here and sulk all day. I know what can fix this. Basketball. Let's go.
No thanks.
This is not negotiable. Let's go.
Come on, I know you're going through some stuff now. Yeah, you feel like giving up now. Your spot is tough now. But how can you learn if you don't fall? How can you walk if first you don't crawl? But through it all, you keep blessing me.
Yeah, I won. Look for one.
You sure did. Ready to talk?
Yeah.
Oh, good job, bro, man. It's so cute. But welcome back, everybody. We received another submission from Millennium Goddess about how she has persevered through hard times. She says, after the passing of 5 family members in a span of 6 years, my mom and I faced financial hardships, leaving us homeless. I was forced to mature and look at things from a different perspective. I longed for a regular childhood, but experiencing such traumatic events as a child pushed me to grow stronger as a person, academically and emotionally. To arrive at this point in my life, I sharpened my focus on school, dance, and books, using them all as an escape. I was determined to provide a better lifestyle for my mom and me. Mm. My favorite part is the last part. She basically sums up her experience by saying, although I had to climb many mountains to get where I am today, I refuse to be a victim. I stand tall at the top of that mountain in my life and in my academic excellence. I do not want to be a product of the environment that I grew up in, but a product of myself.
Mm. Wow. She is very powerful with her words.
And she writes well.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's really deep. Trying not to be a product of your environment, it's really tough because that's a major influence mm-hmm. in some people's lives. So yeah. Trying to go away from that is a strong move.
And I think we can all relate, especially since we all grew up in some part of Los Angeles. So. Being that we don't see a lot of minorities kind of graduating or making a path for them to be successful, for mm-hmm. her to say that is great.
Mm-hmm. I think you just need to take control sometimes. And sometimes you do that through writing, like poetry. Mm-hmm. Aaron, you do a little poetry, I've heard?
Oh, I dabble from time to time. You know, it's not all the time.
Well, let's hear it.
I don't know.
Come on, show us what you got. I mean, unless if you can't really... flow.
All right, okay. Keep it moving is what I'm trying to do. Stuck in these muddy waters called love, trying to get close to you. I'm trying to take one step and I will not budge. Trying to reach for land, but I cannot lunge. Trying to move is a hard task when you weren't allowed to be free. So I stand still only because I'm afraid of you and as you stand in front of me. I feel like a statue, my skin is hard like rock to me, but people come around to see what's up with me, and they come to find out they see my skin is soft and squishy. I don't understand what's going on. What am I supposed to do? The reason I say these things is because I feel dead inside. Is that because of me or you? I'm on an island in the middle of the street, surrounded by waters and sharks, and they're trying to attack me. In your presence, I'm at a standstill. I have stopped at a green light, not because I don't see the color green. Obviously, I have stopped to see this Godzilla figure towering over me, and like I'm trembling in my fear. And then to see your face is what brings me to tears. To call you my father is really the question of the year. My mom wonders why I don't respect her, why I don't show her love. I fail to tell her that the man I call my father is what's caused me so much pain that left me in the sun just to rot away. I stayed in my fear, knowing if I moved, I would be pushed away. Just having my heart covered in corrosion of pain. Didn't they expect you to tell me or tell you that I love you? Love is love. Love is brought both ways. Love holds you at night. Love is the reason why I put up with this fight. For love, you failed to give. For the love you said you would fulfill. But I never seemed to see the affection that you failed to give. But I have to keep it moving and keep it moving with my head up. I've been told I may like you, but I have to love you. That's tough. But I will not stay in your human-made shade. Today is the day I will cut the ties with the man who caused me pain. But it creates the feel that I run off today. So it's safe to say, you will no longer hold me back. You cannot make me weak. I will keep moving and not stand in defeat. Because you showed me that I am strong and you became weak. I'm sorry, but I'm running to retreat.
Wow, Aaron, that was really something.
Yeah, that really moved me. Thank you for actually sharing that with us, because a lot of people don't really want to share their experiences, mm-hmm. but that was really well written.
Mm-hmm. That must have been troubling, man.
Man, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do to get through life, and I guess one thing I do is just write poetry and listen to music, so thank you guys.
That's beautiful. Thank you for sharing.
And Jasmine, I've heard you was a little creative.
Oh. Yes, I love drawing. I actually draw all the time.
Oh.
Those stick figures.
Yeah.
Well, let's take a look at her drawings. They're coming up on the screen right now.
What?
Man.
Those are beautiful. I take that thing back.
All right. Right.
Thank you.
Those are so nice, Jasmine. I really, truly have really talented friends.
Except you. Not as shade.
Whoa. Shade.
But anyways, we'll go into a short break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Hallelujah.
Earlier on the show, we asked some viewers to share personal experiences on our hashtag DreamsForever post, and we've heard some powerful submissions. Here's another comment from our viewer at GQ underscore Dawn about high accomplishments in the midst of hardships. I have changed from being distant from others to being accepted of others. To accept differences is essential for growth. Since staying the same and in the same place does not change anything, I forced myself to step outside of my comfort zone to accept that fact. I cannot step back and not allow myself to become a leader. To me, a leader means knowing the right path to take when problems surface. I learned that it is important to be open to others' differences because you can always learn something you did not know before. I will take this message with me, especially through college, because it will give me better focus to know how to approach situations and people I encounter.
Mm. Wow.
That's a deep message.
Yeah, that sounds like a really smart person, whoever he is or she is. You know.
I don't know.
Right. It's really powerful how he acknowledged that he wasn't being a leader. But now he's focused more on, hey, I need to overcome this, like, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I really think that's powerful, looking at things that you need to improve on. And that's something that we all need to do as a community, mm-hmm. basically kind of looking at things that we can improve within ourselves. Mm-hmm. But here's to the last comment posted to our hashtag DreamsForever from our viewer at Brendan B. This viewer offers advice for students entering high school. What I would like people to know is that high school is not a time to procrastinate. And although people think they can slack freshman year, you really can't. High school is a timeline. The habits you create from the beginning are the habits that stick with you throughout your entire high school career, from procrastination to studying every night. If you start off good in high school on a good track, you'll finish in a good track overall. Overall, people just need to understand that your habits are created at early times, and the habits you have from the jump are the habits that you'll keep until you graduate.
That's some great advice I can really attain with that, seeing as I'm in high school, and I've been through a lot of stuff, and, you know, bad grades, come bringing them back up, it's really cool.
Yeah, that makes a whole lot of sense, because I feel like I was going to be like that, trying to come into high school and procrastinate, but someone told me just stay on your grades and stuff like that, because they'll push you forward. But, Karan, we're so glad that you came up to our show today.
Yeah.
But before you go, we hear that you have a special performance for us.
I prepared a little song. I like everyone. I'd like to, you know, wait for everyone. Is that okay?
Yeah,
that sounds like a yes, but well, don't go away. We're going to hear Karan's performance before we come back after this short little break.
Hey, Jamila.
Yeah. It's crazy how we finna graduate.
Honestly. We're 3 months away from high school graduation. It just seems like yesterday we were graduating from middle school.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Remember we used to sing that song in middle school? Work hard, play hard.
Remember those dances, too? That was wild. It was fun.
But, yeah. Oh. I'll miss y'all when I'm gone.
I know. We really did become a family.
Sure did. Like this.
Really close too. And not even within Dreamers, it's like everybody in the program. Like brothers and sisters, honestly.
Go make me cry.
Oh, Jamila, don't cry. It's okay, girl. It's okay.
Here, performing a live guitar solo, let's give it up for Karan Burner. Woo! Wow, Karan, thank you for your performance. It was truly beautiful. Thanks for everyone who tweeted in today using their hashtag DreamForever. Thanks to all of our co-hosts. It has been a pleasure sitting on the panel with all of you. Thanks for our sponsor, Campbell Hall and the I Have a Dream Foundation Los Angeles. And most importantly, thanks to you, the viewers. Thank you for watching. Have a great night.
That's right, the fire that burns.
The fire that burns deep within.
I know that's right.
You are the joy this world can take away. This spiritual love affair will never end.
Wipe your tears.
Lovely day.
some stuff now.
Yeah.
You feel like giving up now. Your spot is tough now. But how can you learn if you don't fall? How can you walk if first you don't crawl? But through it all, you keep blessing me.
Yeah.
While they pressing me.
Right.
And they testing me.
Yeah.
They keep stressing me.
Right.
Because they never heard a preacher flow.
What?
Show.
Yeah.
Go.
What?
No.
Yeah.
With me. You're so kind to me, Jesus.